Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. My name is Lonnie, and behind the camera is my wife, Connie. I have received a bunch of requests lately to show how I made my handy little container. It's a waterproof container, and so that's what this video is going to be about. I made mine out of orange juice bottles. Couple of them. What you need is a wide neck on it. Whatever bottle you use, it has to have a wide disc on the neck. So let's get right down into the video and get started making it. Here at our remote cabin, so we don't have a whole lot of tools, and I'm just going to use mostly hand tools here to get this job done. I'm using my Swiss Army knife, my Victorinox Swiss Army knife. I'm going to use the saw blade on it to cut the neck off. Now, when you cut this off, what you're looking for is this fat ring right here. Don't cut right up against the ring because you'll damage the ring. We want to save that ring. So you want to cut back from it a little bit. Okay, once I've cut through the bottle like that, then I can go ahead and use my knife blade to cut it off then. You might have to work at this because that's the neck is very stiff right there. Okay, now we need to take off all this. Let's see if we can make it a little clearer here on the white bucket. We need to take off all of this material almost right up to this flat disc. So this is the way I've been doing it. Now this looks dangerous to cut towards myself, but My fingers can only go so far. So it's not as dangerous as it looks. My fingers can't keep driving the blade into my thumb. Now, if you're using a smaller or bigger blade, you'll have to take that into consideration. Okay, once this is all cut down as close as you can get it to the wide disc, let's see, I was in a hurry. I did damage this disc, but we're just going to use this for demonstration purposes right now. Okay, once you've got it down to where it's cut almost to the disc, then sandpaper works real well to finish it off. Lay it on the sandpaper and work it. And what I've done is we only have this much sandpaper here at our cabin. This is all we could find. And as you can tell, it's pretty wore out. So I did find this file. So I would I kept working the bottle top lids on this file, and I would work it for a little bit, and then I'd rotate it. so that I wouldn't, so it all come down evenly. Once I had it down to the flat disc, the wide disc here, then I went to the sandpaper. And you'll want to lay this out on a flat surface. This is not flat. You'll want to lay it on a tabletop or a countertop or something that's very flat. Lay it on there. And then use your bottle top. Lay it on here and just keep sanding it until the whole bottle top is sanded flat, clear across, that there is no longer a ridge sticking up here from the neck of the bottle. This is what you're after. Okay, now that we've gotten this far on two of them, let's go ahead and glue them together. Okay, I'm using super glue, cyanoacrylate, I believe is what it, yes, cyanoacrylate. Super glue is a brand name. We're going to want to put some clear around the whole surface. Okay, that should be pretty good there. All right. Now, we're going to put the two together. Okay, you want to make sure that they're mated well, that one is not offset from the other. So you want them to mate real well. So I placed it down on this to get it in line vertically, and then as you noticed, I pinched it from side to side to get it to align horizontally. After it's sat for a few seconds till it's cured, you have now got your case. And it should be waterproof. If you did a good job of sanding, it should be waterproof. There's your new container. Now, if you want to check it for waterproofness, once you're assured that the glue is completely dry, pour a sink or a pot or something full of hot water, and then seal these off real well, place it down in that hot water, and as the air inside here starts heating up and expanding, if there's a leak, it'll start coming out. The air will start bubbling out that spot where it leaks. If you're not seeing any air bubbling out, chances are you've got it sealed quite well. Well, thanks for watching. I hope you learned something, and we'll see you folks on the next video. You take care.
If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.